It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day in the neighborhood. It's all good. 4-3, Cowboys Nation, 4-3, man. Oh, Lord, it's a good time because, bro, I was watching the game yesterday, man. I was asking myself, do the Dallas Cowboys, with David Irvin being back, do the Dallas Cowboys have one of the best defensive lines in the game? I was surprised that I was asking myself this because I had never asked myself this about the Cowboys ever. So you got David Irvin, who's only been playing for 3 games, and he already has 5 or 6 sacks. You got Tank Lawrence, who leads the league in sacks. So you got a stud in David Irvin, you got a stud in Tank Lawrence, and I believe Crawford is a stud as well. And as I've been saying, man, when David Irvin came back, this is what I expected. This is the balance of pressure that I expected, man. I've always wondered how much better our team could be, man, if we had some kind of solid pass rush on defense. And I don't think the Cowboys really had that ever since DeMarcus Lawrence left, right? So when we drafted Tank Lawrence, you know, the hope came back in the door. And I expected Taco Charlton to be able to do something, but he's kind of like, I understand he's a young guy, he's a rookie, but I haven't heard his name called all season. He almost had a pick yesterday, but whatever. But I believe that we have one of the top defensive lines in the game. And it's not me just saying it as a biased opinion. What I'm saying is essentially being backed up because the sack leader, the NFL sack leader on our team. So I just want to give a shout out to the Cowboys general, man. Jerry Jones, man, they draft well, bro. We really do draft well, man. To be able to find Tank Lawrence, to be able to find Jalen Smith, be able to find Dak Prescott, Z, Dez. We drafted all of these guys. So when you throw in a dominant defensive line to combat our dominant offensive line, that's just a recipe for success, man. For real. And I can't believe Zeke fumbled yesterday. I think that was his first fumble all season on the first carry, bro. But whatever, we still got what we had. We still got, you know, business taken care of. But when Zeke, and you know, all the analysts said, when Zeke is running the ball like that, having that many yards per carry and stuff like that, man, Cowboys are gonna be hard to beat, bro. Another game, third straight game of 100 yards, bro. So shout out Zeke, man. I'm telling y'all, man, it's something. I don't know what happened, but something clicked in Zeke. And these last 3 games, he done woke up, man. Because at the beginning of the season, his body language was just telling me that I don't really care, bro. I'm nonchalant. I'm not really engaged. But he's a different person now, man. He's got that burst. He's got that speed back. Man, so shout out to him, man. But we almost lost this shit. We almost lost this game, bro. It was so many stupid penalties, bro. It was so many, like, missed opportunities that we had. Like, this game, even though it was 33-19, we really should have put up 40 against this team. If I'm keeping it honest, bro. We really should have put up 40, bro. It's like, our starting point was right here, and all we had to do was go on a straight path to right here to get to the finishing point. All we had to do was go from here to here. But instead of going from here to here, we want to go here, we want to go here, we want to go here, we want to do a loop-de-loop, we want to go back and talk to Mama, we want to talk to Uncle Elroy from down the street, we want to make a piss off at the gas station or get some black and mild, some yak. We want to do all this stuff. And then we want to finally get to the ending point, which is the W, bro. I mean, like, it was really stuff that was really about to... There was a point in time where I thought, when I was watching the game, I thought I was going to pass away. I thought I was going to die. I thought I was going to pass away, and then somebody was going out. Wasn't nobody going to know. They was going to end up, I was going to be dead for so long that the room was going to start to stink, and somebody was going to have to come take my ass up out of here. Because I'm telling you, without Dan Bailey, bro, I don't know. Well, Cowboys fans probably can agree with me with this. Dan, I never knew the importance of a kicker. I mean, you know the importance of a kicker, bro. Obviously, you know, nobody else can really do what he does as well as he does on the team. But you never notice that importance until it's gone, bro. And so Dan Bailey's gone, and we got this other dude, Nugent or whatever. And this fool kicking, missing field goals. The first field goal he said he missed, and it's just kicking my ass already. Then we scoring touchdowns, and the touchdowns getting called back cause of flags. Dez Bryant had a long reception that got called back cause of a flag, bro. It's just all of our big. It's just draining when big plays get negated because of penalties, man. It's literally the most draining thing about football. If you play the game long enough, man, some good things are gonna happen for you eventually, man. So I definitely believe that the turning point was when we blocked that kick. We blocked that field goal, And I remember tweeting it, bro. I told my followers, y'all remember that play, because that's going to be the turning point of the game. And I think we scored like 16 straight points after that, bro. I was low-key feeling type of way that Skandrick didn't score that touchdown, bro. I was like, man, this dude trash, bro. He trash. I guess Shorty just ran out of gas or something, bro. But I was like, man, that's got to be a touchdown. Every time that stuff type of stuff happened, I think to myself, Ed Reed would have scored that touchdown. Ed Reed was not about to get tackled, bro. He was taking it to the house. You hear me? Yeah, that was definitely the turning point of the game, bro. I remember telling myself when we were down, I don't really too much worry about the offensive end when we're down, man. As far as us like coming back and getting back in the game, because Dak has showed so much poise this last year and a half that he done earned my respect. So I don't really too much worry when we're down. It's just always defense that give me cause to pause, bro. But our defense is slowly but surely coming along, man. Our defensive line, for me, our defensive line is like better than what I expected it to be. Jalen Smith, Sean Lee, and those guys, they're better than what I expected it to be. I didn't realize that we didn't have no interception until yesterday, since week two, man. But shout out Byron Jones for getting the pick six. I can't remember the last time I seen us get a pick six, bro. It was probably goddamn Terrence Newman or somebody. I don't know. But I ain't gonna lie, bro. One thing did kind of bother me yesterday, bro. I didn't like the fact, I don't know the dialect of it, but it looked to me as if Dez Bryant, in the midst of us coming back and winning this game, it looked to me like Dez Bryant was complaining, man, and, you know, complaining about, I guess, targets. Because, you know, if y'all watch the game, y'all saw him on the sideline going like this, man. And at the time of the game, he only had two targets. So a lot of people have assumed that it was him holding up two fingers talking about two targets. But since Dez has since came out and refuted and said he was calling out the coverage that the defense was in, which is cover two. And I don't remember seeing them. Well, they probably did play cover two, but I don't recall them seeing playing cover two. I remember seeing a lot of man, bro. But if Dez was really complaining about touches in the midst of a comeback win, bro, it's just not a good look, Shorty. I respect Dez, man, but Dez definitely is one of those characters with an ego, bro. He's not a quiet superstar, bro. He's not Larry Fitzgerald. He's not one of these quiet Calvin Johnson. He's not one of these quiet wide receivers, bro. Dez is very vocal. He's the heart and soul of the Cowboys team, in my opinion, bro. So it's just like, man, that's just not something I want to see as a Cowboys fan. It makes him look selfish. It makes him look like he's all about him. We in the midst of this, we at battle, we at war, and we coming back, and we getting victories, and you complaining about touches. It's just not a good look. In high school, my coach had a term for players who behave like they called them a cancer. Guys who were all about me. Guys who played me ball despite the success of the team. And that's definitely cancer-like behavior, man. You, in the midst of a victory, you know, complaining about whatever it is, personal issues that you got on the field with your team and your teammates, even though y'all doing good things. That's definitely cancer, bro. And that can spread. And that's why when you sense a cancer in the locker room, you got to cut it and you got to get rid of it to spare the whole body before it spreads. But that's just the way it looks, bro. I definitely hope that's not really the case with Dez, bro, because he's an amazing talent. My favorite player in the NFL easily. So, you know, but I'm objective, bro. I didn't like what I saw from Dez, bro. And, you know, just get it regulated, bro. Because I feel like we hitting our stride right now. We hitting our stride. All the bullshitting we was doing in the beginning of the season, Zeke is playing better, Dak is playing better. Our defense looked amazing yesterday. We got to shore up some tackles, man. I seen Xavier Woods miss a big tackle because we kept letting them have life. Xavier Woods missed a tackle on a running back that would have stopped him on fourth down. It would have stopped him and turned the ball over on downs, but he missed a tackle and he got the first down and they still had life. We gotta shore up those ends, man, because that we could have easily lost that game. That game could have went a different way, bro. But all in all, bro, D-Law, he going for the defensive MVP this year, bro. He about to be the sack leader. That's just what I feel in my heart, man. And we good, bro. Like, we head on the right path, bro. I saw improvement. That's what you hope to see. I saw improvement again this week, man. We got a tough, tough matchup next week against Kansas City. But most importantly, we got this division win, bro. Somebody believe the Eagles. No, we on their ass. You hear me? That's it for this segment, man. Guys, kings, and queens, man. Always remember to love somebody and hug somebody. You're here today and you're going today, man. If y'all like this content, subscribe, comment, like, share it, do whatever, man. But just know I'm gonna be uploading more and more content as always, man. That's what I do, man. Cowboys Nation, I'm out.